is called Ants in My Bed, and it's about a child's summer vacation at the shore with his grandma. And the small beach town life that he is experiencing is much different than what he's used to. And that's because he lived in the city. So he gets to learn about different things. One of the things that he's going to learn about is how to build sandcastles. Have you done that?
Yes.
Yeah. You guys are like 3 blocks from the beach. So today, one of the things that we're going to do is we're going to read to find out about his experience building sandcastles. We're going to find out what he experiences. Sound good?
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to take a minute to become word nerds.
Yeah.
I'm going to have you repeat after me. My turn, moat. Your turn.
Moat.
My turn, moat. Your turn.
Moat.
Clap it out. Clap out that syllable. My turn, moat. Your turn. Excellent. Talk to me about moat. People are thinking. Wondering. People are saying, I don't know what that means. Do you think?
I don't know if this is correct, but it sort of sounds like boat, so I'm saying, like, a moat is, like, those things where you tie your boat so it won't, like, float away.
Let's see, she's seeing moat and boat rhyme, so is it where you tie your boat? We don't know, we're gonna put a little star by that one, okay?
I think that was
quite dark. I have another hard one. This one is my turn. Cedar shakes, your turn.
Cedar shakes.
My turn. Cedar shakes, your turn.
Cedar shakes.
How many syllables is the, are those
three.
Two words?
Three.
Three. Can you talk to me about cedar shakes? You guys are saying no. That's definitely not one that I know. So we're going to come across these when we read today, so we're going to want to think about them, okay? So when he's building sandcastles, we're going to hear about these words. Who wants to be my word nerd today? All right, your job as we read today is if you see another word that you think the rest of the group should know, you're gonna write it on here, okay? So when we come back together later, you're gonna be the word nerds. Okay, could you all do me a favor and look at the cover of this book? Read the title with me.
Ants in My Bed.
Okay, one of the things that we're gonna do today is we're gonna use a strategy where we focus on the illustrations. What are the illustrations?
The pictures.
The pictures. And we're very lucky because we have a color copy here. So we're going to be looking at the illustrations. Later, we're going to be using this book to talk about the mood of the story because that's something important for us to think about, okay? For now, can you please open to page 3? What do we see here? The table of contents. So I told you that today we're going to be reading to learn about his experience building sandcastles. Where will we find the sandcastles?
Page.
Page at the beach. Yeah, that makes sense too. Or in the table of contents, what page do we see?
Page 5.
Let's go to page 5. So there's the sandcastle part. But actually, before we even learn about how he builds sandcastles, I also want to be able to read the introduction so we can find out who this boy is and why he's at his grandma's house, okay? Since you are in fourth grade, I'm going to have us do some silent reading. So I'm going to have you silently read to think about his experience building these sandcastles. For now, I'm going to listen in on Jesse. Jesse's going to whisper read for me. But he's not going to be reading for too long, but don't get distracted by him, okay? All right, you may begin. Start with the introduction. All right, Jesse, you are going to read for me beginning right here.
When I was 9 years old, I spent the summer with my grandmother, large gray cedar shapes. I was at the seashore. I stayed in the yellow bedroom where my father slept as a boy. The room's window faced the ocean, and the sound of the waves breaking against the shore always helped me sleep. At least it did until the aunt showed up a few weeks into my visit. I spent the first 2 weeks exploring the sea and saving the lives of some horseshoe crabs that I also went to see the riding the old bike Grams from Jim gave me. I was not allowed to ride very far on the weekends because the town and the beach became crowded with tourists during the week. I explored as I could.
Good, can you hold on 1 second? So tell me a little bit about his first few weeks at his grandma's house. What's going on?
He's exploring the beach.
What else is he doing?
He's making spectacles.
He's going to be, right?
Yeah.
And so, what did Jim give him?
A bike.
Gave him a bicycle. I'm going to have you do this part for me, too.
And Jim usually drops by in the morning to eat breakfast with Grandma, and sometimes he sticks around to help Grandma put chores in the house. Other times he would take me down to the shore and teach me how to make sandcastles.
Can I ask you a question? Who is Jim?
He's the kid's great grandmother's friend.
Great. That's his grandma's friend, right? I'm going to have you continue reading for sandcastles by yourself, okay? Did everyone have an opportunity to finish the part about the sandcastles?
Yes.
Okay, find a comfortable spot where you're ready to stop. When you find a comfortable spot when you're ready to talk to me, just show me by turning to page 5. It looks like most of you are heading back to page 5 now. One of the things that I asked you to do today was to think about how he experiences building sandcastles. I'd like you two to turn and talk about his experience. You two, and I'm going to talk to Jesse. Talk about his experience building sandcastles.
Wow.
What was his experience?
Well, he does use a lot of his supplies from making stuff like cups, buckets, spoons, shovels, and garden tools.
You know, he's a very careful person, isn't he? He wants it to be
I love how you're going back in the text and looking for some evidence. What did you find out about? What did you find out about his experience? Talk to me.
That he uses like different kinds of things, like cups, buckets, spoons, shovels, and garden tools to like build his sandcastles.
Jesse said that he was a very careful sandcastle builder. Was there anything else that you learned about his experience with the sandcastles that you want to share?
He always tried to look for different ways to make sandcastles special.
Sure. Did you want to add to that? Okay. You were going to say the same thing because the two of you turned and talked. Okay. One of the things that we're going to look at today is the illustrations, because we want to talk about the mood of the story or what kind of feeling we get from this. So if you look on page 5, I want you to look at that picture very carefully. We're going to zoom in on the illustration to think about the mood or the feeling that the picture gives us and how that picture supports the text. So let's talk about that for a little bit. When we think about mood, we usually think about feelings. And so in third grade, you probably heard feelings like happy or sad. But in fourth grade, there's more moods than just happy and sad. What do you think about his mood in that picture on page 5? What's the mood or the feeling?
He looks calm, happy, relaxed.
Did you say vegged out?
Yeah.
What does that mean, vegged out?
I don't know.
Vegged out.
I heard of it and I was like saying it.
You're so funny that you use that. Because usually when you're vegged out, you're so relaxed that nobody can bother you. He's very focused on building that sandcastle.
He looks like he's concentrated into it.
Absolutely. And I like how you say that he's relaxed, he's calm, he's vegged out. The mood of this story would be a lot different if the illustration showed him running and kicking sand on people. Don't you hate when that happens?
Yeah.
All right, so let's look at page 6. I don't know that the mood has changed. It looks like he's still pretty vegged out, as you said. He's calm, he's relaxed, he's very careful. What is he doing in this scene that we learned about in the text?
It looks like he's like putting, it says that he's like putting, like collecting seashells and like sea glass to put on the sandcastles to make them special.
Absolutely. He's very focused in this. Would you like to add?
Adding details, like pressing wet sand together in his hands and spooting it up into lookout towers.
Excellent. Now let's look at page 7. There's another mood here. He's still pretty focused. He's still pretty calm. But now we have like a different kind of mood. What do you see here? Definitely. He's focused on finding new things. So the mood is that he's focused and learning something new. There's also a mood that Jim adds to the picture. And that is that he is
helping.
He's a helping friend.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Do you know, I have to show you something interesting about this text. Go back to page 5. You know there are some fourth graders who, before reading the story, don't like the illustration on page 5, because if they don't know who Jim is, what might they think he is in that picture on page 5 if they're not reading the text?
Maybe like a stranger
just walking by.
Some people have thought that the mood was that he was a stranger, because it looks like the young boy is alone, but we know that that's not the case in the story. Jesse pointed out to me that Jim is actually Grandma's best friend, okay? Do me a favor and close your book. You did an awesome job with that. Can you tell me, why does looking at the illustration help you as a reader? How does that help you as a reader?
If something doesn't make sense, if you look at the illustrations, it can actually kind of give you a clue sometimes to like what it's about.
Sure, and it's telling us not only what it's about, but the, what was that M word?
Mode.
The mood, not moat.
No.
The mood. We're gonna talk about moat in a minute though. Yes.
He also helps like show you where the setting is.
Sure, and you know what was really nice? You guys were able to really think about how he was calm and relaxed, and as you said, vegged out. That's a good mood. Okay, we're going to be word nerds for one last time. You didn't find anything that you thought we would know? That's okay. We'll hold this one blank for now. But in the meantime, these are the two words that we didn't know. Did anybody figure out what a moat was when they read today? Jesse, I'm going to go to you. What was a moat?
I already know, but...
You didn't tell us? What is it?
I know, but it's when you dig like a circle on the ground and you fill water in it, and then the sandcastle goes in the middle.
I love it. It's a ditch that's filled with water, and usually it's keeping people out. Do you remember Beauty and the Beast where they had the moat? Oh, nice job with that. So you're my word nerd for moat. I can't believe you knew and didn't tell us. And the last one, this was cedar shakes. Did anybody figure out what this was?
No.
Do you think so?
Maybe it's some kind of shake.
I'm gonna share with you the sentence from the story. Graham lived in a large gray cedar shakes house at the seashore.
I was going to say it.
What is it?
It's probably a kind of house.
It's a wood house kind of thing.
It's a type of
it's
wood.
A red kind
cedar.
Of wood.
If you know the word cedar, you'll think of a tree. They are wood shingles that are cut from red cedar trees. So she has this old, beautiful wooden house at the beach. That is a cedar shakes house. Which the cedar shakes house actually contributes to the mood of the story, because if you were living in this kind of house, you'd probably be pretty vegged out.
Yeah.
It's a very relaxing place to live. Nice job today, readers. I'm impressed.